right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the 7 p.m. Yoga Flow and Yoga Nidra. We'll be starting in just a few minutes. Get settled in. Oh, also, if you have any props like a blanket or a block, or if you're at home, if you have a pillow you can grab, go ahead and grab it, because for the beginning part, we will be lying down and I want you to have something underneath you to lift you up if you can. If not, don't even worry about it. All right, we'll start here in a little bit. You also get settled in. Hello, Rebecca and Jackie. Without my Palo Santo. In case you missed it, go ahead and grab a couple of blocks if you have them, or blankets, a pillow, a sofa cushion, whatever you have that you might be able to put underneath you for the beginning of class so we can lie down on our mats. And if you don't have any of that stuff, don't even worry about it. Have a couple more minutes, y'all. Hey, Nancy. All right. Again, if you missed it and you're just tuning in, if you by chance have any blocks, a blanket, a pillow, a sofa cushion, anything that you can put underneath you so that your chest is above your head, go ahead and grab that and then settle in on your mat. We'll give it about another minute or two so that people can start tuning in, or more people can start tuning in, and then we'll begin. Hey, Monica. Hey, Lisa. Hey, 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 it's a party up in here. And again, I have my lovely assistant slash husband, Miguel. Oh, something else, in case y'all didn't know, for those of you that know Miguel, he actually started his teacher training this past week. And so we have a future yoga teacher with us as well. You know, the QMY family is expanding. Okay, y'all, we are, Nancy says, hola, husband. All right, we're gonna start, y'all, so go ahead and get situated on your mat. And to begin with, we're gonna actually start lying flat on our backs. Now, if you have blocks or something to elevate your heart, I'm gonna show you what to do. So if you have blocks with you, I want you to put one block between your shoulder blades. It'll be running up and down your spine, so like this. And we'll lie down the other. So one block between your shoulder blades. And then the second block, if you have one, put it behind your head. Now, if you don't have blocks, again, don't worry about it. You can put, roll up a blanket like a burrito, put it along your spine, allow your head to drop off, or if not, just lie flat on your mat. It does not matter. Just get comfortable here. So I'm gonna give you a moment to settle in. As I settle in as well. And you can move around a little bit, get yourself situated, adjust your clothes, adjust your position. I'm gonna get the music started. can go ahead and start closing your eyes if you haven't already. Tonight's class is gonna be a little bit more gentle than Tuesday's was. We're still gonna move, of course. We're still gonna work as we always do. But we're gonna also take a little more time to relax tonight. So start connecting to your breath. Just the natural rhythm of your inhale and your exhale through your nose. Allow the ground to fully support you in this moment. Give up all effort in your physical body. Let the ground do all the work. Let your breath be natural, flowing in and out through your nose. And again, start to let go of whatever has been happening in your life right now. While you're lying here on your mat with your eyes closed, the one thing and the only thing you know to be real and true is your breath, flowing in and out through your nose. Start to feel the temperature of the room that you are in against your skin. Feel your clothes resting on your body. Observe any sounds that you hear around you, whether from the video or the space that you are in. Everything soften a little bit more. From deep within your body, imagine this wave of relaxation starting to radiate out from your bones, out towards your muscles, to the joints, to your fascia, to your skin. Everything softens a little bit more. Let all the tension melt away. Let your body sink into the earth. Come back to your breath in and out through your nose. And start to deepen the breath. As you inhale, breathe into your belly, fill it up. As you exhale, empty out, draw your navel in towards your spine. Again, inhale, fill the belly up, let it grow. Exhale, empty out, navel to spine. Keep going just like this, deep breaths into the belly. Now while you're lying here connecting to your breath, I invite you to set an intention for your practice. What is it that you need on your mat right now? Keep connected to the breath, stay in the body, and let the answer come to you. Don't go up into the head to try to figure it out. And there's no right or wrong answer, so keep breathing through it. And whatever it is that you need, start to repeat it to yourself internally as if it's already happening in this moment for you. And feel it to be the truth. Stay connected to the breath. Keep repeating your intention to yourself. You'll go ahead and let your intention drift away. Stay connected to your deep breath and start to wake your body back up, bringing small movements into the fingers and into your toes. If it feels okay for your neck as it is right now, gently rock your head from side to side. Now, if you have a prop underneath you, go ahead and make your way onto one side so you can remove whatever it is out and set it to the side. Once you're flat on your back again, hug your knees into your chest. Find a gentle rock from side to side. Stay connected to the breath. Feel this movement in the back, in your spine. See how it feels for you right now. Then keep your right knee hugged into your chest. Extend your left leg out in front of you. Flex both feet, spread the toes wide, and pinky toes draw back towards you. Now we're going to add movement with our breath. Stay here on the ground. Everyone inhale big. As you exhale, draw your nose up towards your knee. Again, inhale, lower your head back down onto the earth. Exhale, nose to knee. Inhale, head to the earth. Keep your feet flexed. Exhale, nose to knee. Take two more rounds on your own breath pace. Last one. On your inhale, lower your head back down onto the mat. Straighten your right leg up, grab the back of your thigh, and press up through your heel. So your right foot is flexed, you're reaching your toes down towards you. Keep pressing up through the heel. Big breaths, breathe into the back of that right leg, wherever you may be feeling tension. Soften the jaw. We have one more big breath here. Hug your right knee back into your chest, supine twist. Take your left hand, grab onto the right knee, drop the knee over towards the left side. Right shoulder stays down as much as possible, and your gaze can either be up towards the ceiling or over the right shoulder. Keep breathing into the belly and into your lower back. On your next inhale, come back to center, and we switch. Right leg extends out in front of us, left knee hugs into our chest. Flex your feet, spread the toes wide, activating your feet. Again, everyone inhale big. Exhale, nose to knee. Inhale, head to the earth. Exhale, nose to knee. Keep going on your own, three more rounds. Stay in the body as you're moving here. Feel the movement as it's happening, not before, not after. Last one. Just take me to places I've never known. Inhale your head to the earth. Straighten your left leg up. Grab the back of your thigh. Press up through your left heel. Keep your left foot flexed so your toes are reaching down towards you. Stay with the breath. One more big breath here. Press up your heel a little more. And as you exhale, bend the knee, bring it back into your chest. Supine twist. Take your right hand, take your left knee over towards the right side. Left shoulder stays down as much as possible. And again, your gaze can either be up right above you or over the left shoulder. Have two more big breaths here. As you inhale, come back to center. Hug both knees back into your chest. Start to rock and roll front to back. Take about 4 to 5 rocks, giving your spine some more love. And once
once you're ready, you're gonna come all the way forward, crossing the shins, plant your hands out in front of you, transition to 4 points, tabletop position, hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. We go into 6 rounds of cat-cow, and you can do a freestyle cat-cow. Just simply move your body however you would like here, or you can follow me. Now inhale, cow, whatever variation or whatever movement you want. Exhale, cat, round your spine, gently tuck your tailbone and chin. Again, if you're doing traditional, inhale, cow, open your heart forward, gaze up towards the ceiling. Exhale, cat, round your spine, gently tuck your tailbone and chin. Keep going, 4 more rounds, whatever you need. Now I'm gonna start to freestyle it as Miguel stays with your traditional cat-cow. You have 3 more breaths. Everyone come back to neutral, tabletop position. Extend your right leg back, tuck your toes under, press back through your right heel. We'll breathe here just a couple moments. And then we switch, bring your right knee back forward, left leg back. Tuck the toes, press back through your left heel. Stay with the breath, you've got this. And release. Now bring your knees together, tuck your toes under, come back to sit onto your heels. So it's gonna look like this. The toes are tucked. Make sure your little pinky toes make it under as well. Sometimes those little guys get left out. We're here. Take your hands behind your back, interlace your fingers, open your heart up towards the sky. Keep breathing. Big breaths. Now straighten back up, keep your hands together, bring your hands onto your right hip, so we're like this. Drop your right ear towards your right shoulder, breathe into the left side of your neck. I know your feet may be feeling a certain way by now, that's perfectly fine, keep breathing through it. We need to stretch the feet out. Release the hands back behind you again, open your heart up, you're reaching your knuckles towards the back edge of your mat. Breathe into the chest. Now straighten back up, hands onto your left hip, drop your left ear towards your left shoulder, breathe into the right side of your neck. We have 1 more big breath here, stay on your feet. And release. Come back to 4 points, tabletop position, untuck the toes, tap the feet out if you need to, wiggle the toes, circle the ankles, whatever you need. And then tuck the toes back under, lift yourself up, downward facing dog, hips up into the air, pedal your feet out while you're here, bending one knee and then the other. Shake your head yes, and shake your head no. On your next inhale, slightly bend your knees, look between your thumbs. Exhale, walk your feet forward to meet your hands. Just a nice, easy walk all the way to the top of the mat. Let your head hang heavy. Interlace your fingers, place them behind your head, and find a rock from side to side. Keep pressing down through your feet. Stay with your breath. Release your hands back down towards the earth. Heel toe your feet out towards the edges of your mat or a little bit past the edges of your mat. Ground your right hand down underneath your heart center. You can tent your fingers here or bring your palm all the way down. Twist, reach your left arm up. Now don't let your hips shift as you're twisting. Keep them as centered as possible. This is more of a spinal twist. Also, if you have a block, you can always place the block underneath you. and continue to twist. One more big breath here, open up a little more. And as you exhale, drop your left hand to the earth, bring it onto the block or your mat, right arm up, we twist, other way. Try to keep your legs as straight as possible. If you have a bend in the knees, that is perfectly fine. Don't worry about it. You have one more big breath here. Open up a little more. And exhale, release right hand back down onto the mat. If you're using a prop, go ahead and move it to the side. Heel toe, your feet back underneath your hips. Everyone inhale, half lift. Bring the weight into the toes. Make a seven with your body. Exhale, fold forward, release. Again, inhale, half lift. Shine the heart forward. Exhale, let it go. Last one, inhale, half lift. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise all the way up. Arms towards the ceiling. Exhale, hands to the heart center. We're going to begin tonight with the moon salutation. So listen and follow closely. Inhale, arms up. Hold your breath as you halfway fold forward. Exhale, release your hands to the earth. Inhale, bring your feet to the edges of your mat, yogic squat. We're gonna stay here and marinate for a few breaths in our yogic squats. Keep opening your heart up, pressing the palms together. Big breaths, soften the face. As you exhale, plant the hands, bring your left leg back, drop your knee down onto the earth. Inhale, arms rise. Give me a small back bend. We're gonna breathe here for some moments. Keep lengthening through your spine. Keep your core active. One more big breath here. And as you exhale, drop your hands down. Take a child's pose. Right foot comes back. Knees out towards the edges of your mat. Big toes to touch. And head to the earth if you can make it there. Take a couple more breaths here. Last big breath. On your next inhale, slide your body forward and come onto your belly. You're sliding all the way forward. Bring your forearms onto the mat, going into a Sphinx pose. So we're doing a little bit of a different variation right now. Elbows underneath the shoulders, ground the tops of your feet and your pelvis into the earth. Reach your heart forward. We're gonna breathe here. Now add some traction. So what I mean by that is you're drawing your elbows back towards your hips so you find extra lengthening in your lower back. Now my pelvis is pressing down so it's not going anywhere, but my elbows are reaching back. I'm lengthening through my spine even more. One more big breath here. And as you exhale, bring your hands back, push yourself into a child's pose again. We have one big breath here. As you inhale, come up onto your knees, circle your arms back behind you, open your heart and your throat. Exhale, plant the hands, step your right foot forward. Inhale, arms rise, lengthen through the spine, shoulders are soft. Exhale, left foot meets the right, fold forward. Hold the breath out as you halfway lift. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Going to the other side now, inhale, arms rise. Retain the breath, halfway fold. Exhale, release. Inhale, yogic squat again. We're gonna stay here for some breaths. Keep opening your heart up. Stay with the breath. Maybe take a moment to close your eyes here. Check in with yourself. On your exhale, plant your hands. Right leg steps back, knee to the ground. Inhale, arms rise. Give me a back bend. We're going to stay here for some breaths. Keep pressing your right hip flexor and right quad forward, getting some opening here.
Again, shoulders are soft, core is active. You have one more big breath here. And as you exhale, drop your hands to the mat. Child's pose, left leg comes back. We'll take two breaths here. Breathe into your hips, into your lower back. On your next inhale, come forward into your Sphinx pose. Slide all the way forward onto your belly. Forearms onto the earth. Elbows are underneath your shoulders. Press into the tops of the feet. Keep reaching your heart forward. And big breaths. Now, typically in this part, we go into a cobra. But for this one right now, we're going into a Sphinx pose. Again, draw the elbows back a little more towards the hips. Find extra space in your lower spine. We have one more breath here. And as you exhale, press it back. Child's pose. We have one breath. As you inhale, come up onto your knees. Circle the arms back. Let your heart shine again. Exhale, plant your hands. Left foot steps forward. Inhale, arms rise up. Exhale, plant your hands, right foot meets the left. Hold the breath out, halfway lift. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, hands to your heart center, and we're gonna flow through it. Inhale, arms up. Hold the breath, halfway fold forward. Exhale, release hands to the earth. Inhale, yogic squat. We're here just for the inhale. Exhale, left leg back, knee to the ground. Inhale, the arms rise. Exhale, child's pose. Inhale, slide forward into a cobra, not a Sphinx pose, but a cobra. Exhale, press your way back, child's pose. Inhale, up onto the knees, arms circle back. Exhale, plant the hands, right foot comes forward. Inhale, arms rise, navel to spine. Exhale, left foot meets your right. Hold the breath out, halfway lift. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, hands to your heart center. We have one more side, y'all. Inhale, arms up. Retain the breath, halfway fold. Exhale, release. Inhale, yogic squats, just for the inhale. Exhale, right leg back, knee to the earth. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, child's pose. Inhale, slide forward onto your belly into a cobra. Exhale, back, child's pose. Inhale, up onto the knees, arms circle behind you. Exhale, hands to the mat, left foot steps forward. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to the earth, right foot meets your left. Hold the breath out as you halfway lift. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Stay here for some breaths. Big breaths into the belly. One more big breath. And we're gonna take it through three rounds of Sun A. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, chaturanga, high to low plank. If you need to, drop your knees here. That's perfectly fine. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, down dog, hips up into the air. Stay here just a few breaths. Stay active through the entire back chain of your body. I'm going to show you on Miguel. I want you to keep lengthening through the whole spine, reaching your sit bones up towards the ceiling, pressing into your hands, and at the same time, you're dropping your heels down
towards the earth. One more big breath here. Inhale, slightly bend the knees, look between your thumbs. Exhale, step your feet to your hands. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, hands to your heart center. We go again. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, Chaturanga. Again, use your knees if you would like. Inhale, Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale, Down Dog, hips up into the air. We go straight through for our last one. Inhale, slightly bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, feet to your hands. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Last one, you got this. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, Chaturanga. Inhale, Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale, Down Dog. Inhale, your right leg up into the air. Exhale, plant your right knee by your right thumb, going into a half pigeon pose. So ideally, your right knee is shooting directly out from your right hip. Your right foot is opening up towards the left edge of the mat. If this is just a little bit too much for you, get out of it. You can bend your knees or straighten the legs a little bit more. Maybe you bring your ankle onto your knee and you're here. So you have this variation or what Miguel is doing. I'm gonna go back to the half pigeon. Now while you're here, as you inhale, lengthen your heart up, reach it towards the sky. Exhale, bow forward. Maybe you keep the hands down, maybe this time you bring them off the mat. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, bow forward. You have two more rounds just like this. Last one, inhale up. This time as you exhale, bow forward, walk your hands out in front of you. If you need some support for that right hip, you can always take a block or a blanket, a pillow, place it underneath your hip, and you stay here. We're gonna marinate here in this half pigeon for some time. Now, if you feel like you need to take this one a little bit deeper, you can always take your left arm and thread it underneath the right. Bring the left side of your head onto the mat. If not, stay exactly where you are. And something that I do want to remind you all of is this is your practice, so you do exactly what your body is asking you for. If it doesn't want to do some of the poses I'm telling you to go into, you don't have to do it. Remember, this is for you. This is what you need. We have three more big breaths here. Last big breath, breathe into your belly. Now, if your left arm's underneath the right, go ahead and unwind. Everyone start to walk your hands back. We're gonna stay here in our half pigeon. You're gonna start to bend the left knee, and with your left hand, reach back. See if you can maybe grab onto your ankle or your foot, and if you can't grab onto it, that's perfectly fine. Keep reaching back. If you have a hold of it, bring it forward. Draw that left hip forward and the left shoulder. Keep breathing here. We have two more big breaths. Not the one that we need right this moment. A little bit too hard for where we're at. All right, last breath here. And release. Drop that left leg back down, left hand onto the mat. Nice and easy, take your time slowly. Come back up into your downward facing dog. Maybe you pedal the feet out here, bending one knee, then the other. We got the other side. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, knee to your thumb. Half pigeon. Again, ideally knee shooting directly out from the hip. Left foot is opening out towards the right edge of your mat. As you inhale, lift your heart up. We lengthen. Exhale, bow forward. Again, hands can stay on the mat, or as you inhale, you lift them off the earth and bring them up with you. Exhale, bow forward. You have two more rounds just like this. Again, stay in the movement as it's happening. See how it feels in your body right now. Not how it did last time you did it, but in this moment. Last one. As you exhale, bow forward, walk your hands out in front of you. We stay here, half pigeon. And same thing as last time. If you want to take it a little deeper, right arm threads underneath left. Bring the right side of your head onto the mat. Keep breathing into the lower belly. You have three more big breaths here. One more breath. And slowly start to unwind. Walk your hands back towards your body. Right knee bends. Bring that heel up. If you can, reach back with the right hand. Grab onto your foot or your ankle. Draw it forward, opening through that right quad. It can feel quite intense sometimes. Breathe into it. More breaths here. Last one. And slowly release. This time we're not going back up into down dog. You're gonna sit onto your left hip. Swing your right leg around out in front of you. Straighten both legs out in front. Flex your feet while you're here. Inhale, arms up, lengthen out of your hips. Exhale, fold forward. If you feel like you need to take it a little deeper and you have a block with you, you can always grab your block, place it in front of your feet. Keep flexing your feet so the toes are reaching back towards you. That really opens up the backs of your legs here. Big breaths. I'm gonna ease out of this and check on something real quick. Keep breathing through that. Two more big breaths here. Last one. Slowly walk your hands back. Bring a small bend into your knees. Slide your forearms underneath the legs. Let the weight of your legs drop onto your forearms. Now while you're here, I want you to round your spine and tuck your chin in towards your chest. We're opening the back channel of the body here. Again, drop the legs on your arms, flex your feet, round the spine, and tuck your chin in. Stay with the breath wherever your mind is wanting to take you. Drop the thoughts, kick the breath back up. One more big breath here. Now slowly release your arms out from underneath you. Come to sit up nice and tall again. From here, we're going to take our right foot. So you have two options. You can bring your right foot to the left inner thigh or the right foot on top of the left thigh. If you're gonna bring it on top, flex your foot while you're here so we don't compromise the knee. Now I want you to draw that right knee down. You can just take to the inner thigh. There you go. I want you to draw the right knee down, but you're opening up from your hip. Keep your left foot flexed. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, fold forward. That one, if you have your leg on your left quad, that can kind of burn sometimes. It does for me. Keep reaching your heart forward. Two more breaths here. Last big breath. And I know our breaths may not be exactly the same, y'all, and that is perfectly fine. Don't even worry about it. Release, walk your hands back. We switch, right leg out in front of you, other side. So left foot can come either to the inner thigh or on top of your right thigh. Again, flex that left foot so you're not compromising the knee. Open, drop that knee down, opening from the hip. Right foot flexed, inhale, arms rise. And exhale, fold forward. Reach your heart forward a little bit more so you have more of a flat back than a rounded spine. Two more breaths here. And if you can't even reach your foot and you're here, that's perfectly fine, y'all. Be okay with wherever you're at because this is a practice for a reason. We're always growing and it's... And release, walk your hands back. Straighten both legs back out in front of you. We're going more into a quad stretch now. So I want you to take your right heel, bring it by your right glute. So you're bending that right knee and then dropping the heel back behind you. You're gonna keep that left leg out in front of you. Bring your hands behind you, walk them back a little. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you're already feeling it a lot in that right quad. You can stay here. If you wanna go a little further, maybe you bring one forearm down onto the mat, maybe both, and you're here. Big breaths. Now, if you're really flexible and you're open through your quads, maybe you even go down all the way onto the mat. Keep that right knee as grounded as possible. Big breaths. Amen. Amen. Soften the body, y'all. Soften the face. Take me to church. We're not here to add a lot of extra tension. We're here to get rid of it. Last breath. Now, wherever you're at, slowly start to rise up. If you're flat on your back, start to push your weight up. If you're on your forearms, bring your hands onto the mat. And then slowly release your right leg out in front. No need to rush, y'all. Take your time. We make our way onto the other side. So left heel comes back by your left glute. Now, if the bunion of your foot, if it hurts too much, you can always double up your mat. Because I know actually on this foot, it does bother me. So I'll double up so I can place it on there. That way I have a little extra cushion. Hands walk back behind you. Now that my mat is out of whack. And then you can stay here or come down onto your forearms. Or maybe you even make your way all the way down onto your back. And know that this side may be different than the other. Maybe the other side you could, this side you can't. That's okay, we're usually not balanced. That's perfectly fine. Big breaths. Three more here. Like a dog at the shrine of your lights. I'll tell you my sins and you can sharpen your knife. Offer me that deathless death and good God. Let me give you my life. Last big breath. The master is our king when the ritual begins. Now wherever you are, start to slowly press your way back up. And slowly, nice and easy, bring that left leg back out in front of you. There's no need to rush, y'all. Not tonight. Take it a little bit more gentle tonight. Straighten the legs out in front of you. Flex your feet. Sit up nice and tall. Reach your arms out in front of you. And slowly, with control, come all the way down onto your back. Take your time, don't rush. If you need a little extra help, grab your thighs, grab the mat, whatever you need. Come all the way down. Once you're flat on your back, hug your knees into your chest and start to rock from side to side. Stamp your feet back down onto the earth. Allow the feet to touch. Open the knees out towards the edges of your mat. Reclining butterfly pose. Breathe here. We're heading into our yoga nidra soon. Stay with the breath. Keep following every exhale or inhale and every exhale. Now slowly bring your knees back to center. Heel toe your feet out towards the edges of your mat. You have two more big breaths here. Heel toe your feet back to center. And then slowly start to flatten out onto your mat again. Take your time. Get comfortable here, whatever that looks like for you. If you have a block, you need to put it maybe underneath the knees here so you can elevate them a little bit. Feel free to do so. If you have a blanket, if you have a block, simply situate yourself to get comfortable. So for those of you who have not experienced a yoga nidra, what it is I'll be guiding you, or I'll be cueing you to feel into certain areas of your body. As I do that, you're simply going to send your awareness into that part of your body. You don't need to move it. You don't need to do anything specific with it. Just let it relax. Now get yourself comfortable. Let go of any control of your breath. Close your eyes. Release any activation that's left in your body. Let's all take a big inhale. Fill the belly up. Open your mouth. Exhale it out. Come back to breathing in and out through your nose. Just the natural rhythm. Start to replace my voice with yours. And I want you to first bring your awareness into the soles of your feet. Feel all sensation in the bottoms of your feet. All sensation in your toes. Feel all the toes. Feel the density of your ankles. Your shins and your calf muscles. Feel the density of your knees. Bring your awareness into your thighs. Let them soften 5% more. Feel into your hips and your glutes. Your belly. Your lower back, let them relax. Your rib cage, the spaces between each rib. The middle of your spine. Your upper back, let the back of your heart open. Allow yourself to receive love. The front of your heart center, whatever barriers you may have around your heart in this moment, let them drop. Whatever weight is on your shoulders right now, let it fall onto your mat. Let your shoulders drop closer to the earth. Like two giant beautiful waterfalls. Feel energy start to flow down both arms, starting at the upper arms, flowing down into the elbows, into your forearms, into your wrists. Feel all the energy in the palms of your hands. And let it continue to flow out through your fingertips. Bring your awareness back up towards your neck and throat. Feel all sensation here. Allow your throat to open up so you can speak your truth with love. Feel into your jaw. Is there any tension here in your jaw right now? If so, can you find the place where tension ends and spaciousness begins? Let go of all tension in your jaw. Let it relax. Feel the density of your teeth. Lips as they gently touch or gently part. Feel your tongue relaxing in your mouth. Your cheeks. The outline of your ears. The place where sound enters your ears. Feel the outline of breath flowing in and out through your nose. Maybe it's a little cooler going in and a little warmer going out. Maybe a little shorter or longer, harder or softer. Allow the backs of your eyes to soften, allowing the eyes to sink deeper into their sockets. Feel your eyelids touching. Allow the eyebrow center to relax. And your forehead smooths out as all thoughts leave your mind, leaving the mind to be like a crystal clear pool of water that you can see all the way to the bottom of. Finally, we bring our awareness up into the top of our head. Feel all sensation on your scalp, the air as it touches your scalp. Allow the crown of your head to start opening, and any tension that is left in your body, allow it to flow up and out through the top of your head, allowing you to lie here in deep and complete relaxation.
start to bring a deeper breath into your body. In your own time, bring small movements back into your fingers and into your toes. Gently rock your head from side to side. And give yourself a good morning stretch. Reach your arms up and over the head. Point your toes out in front of you. Nice and easy, make your way onto one side into a fetal position. As you're ready, start to press your way up into a seated meditation pose. And we'll meet with our eyes closed and hands at heart center in prayer posture. We'll seal off tonight's practice with one clearing breath, followed by a collective Om. Everyone inhale deeply. Open the mouth, exhale it out. Inhale for Om. Om. Thank you all so much for giving yourselves the gift of yoga tonight. From my heart to yours, Namaste. Namaste. All right, y'all. Thank you for joining us tonight. I hope you're able to utilize this video and able to relax some. Know that we love you all so much. Thank you so much for joining. Also, stay tuned because this weekend we will have more classes so you can see what other live videos we will be having. Also tonight on CBS News Channel 4, there will be an interview featuring yours truly. I'll be talking about all these live videos just so we can spread the word throughout the valley, because honestly, this is a time where we all really and truly need this. I need this for myself. I know everyone could really utilize this because, like I always say, we need to feed the love, and that always starts with us. We need to feed ourselves. We need to love ourselves because that is how we give to others. And yeah, if you are gonna post also about this class, please tag Quiet Mind Yoga. We would love to see y'all's videos or pictures. I love y'all very much, and you're very, very, very welcome. Namaste. We love y'all. Bye.
#QuietMindYoga